So in the previous class, we have seen vapor phase epitaxy. Okay, so in that vapor phase epitaxy, we have seen like what are the different chemicals and chemical formulas that is used to obtain the silicon epitaxial layer that is to be deposited onto the substrate. Similarly, there is another technique that is used to deposit a thin layer of epitaxy onto the substrate. So that method is molecular beam epitaxy. So into this molecular beam epitaxy, it is having some advantages with respect to the vapor phase epitaxy, and it is having some disadvantages also. So we will be seeing like what are the advantages and what are the disadvantages of molecular beam epitaxy. In short, it is called MBE. Okay, so this MBE is a non-CVD's chemical vapor deposition. So vapor deposition, okay, so vapor deposition method is a type of chemical vapor deposition. Okay, so this is chemical vapor deposition epitaxy, okay, or we call it vapor phase epitaxy. Okay, so this type of epitaxy uses chemical actually. Okay, so it is using chemical, or we call it chemical, or there is a chemical, it will be having chemical reactions. Okay, but in case of molecular beam epitaxy, there is no chemical reactions will be taking place. So what are the disadvantages of using a chemical was, if we are going to use chemical, then there is a chance of you can say defect into the growth. Okay, so there is a high chance of defect into the growth in vapor phase epitaxy or epitaxy that is having chemical, or it is having chemical reactions. Okay, so there is a high chance of defect, some defect into this epitaxial technique. So the next technique that we will be studying is molecular beam epitaxy. So in molecular beam epitaxy, the method that is used is evaporation method. So evaporation method means, instead of having a chemical reaction to be taking place so that it is to be deposited onto the substrate, or some gas is to be flow, here in molecular beam epitaxy we will be using an evaporation method. Like whatever the silicon we need to deposit onto a substrate, the silicon will be evaporated by using electron gun. Okay, and that after evaporating that silicon atoms by using electron gun, these atoms will be deposited onto the surface one by one like a layer. This layer will be brick like layer, like we put bricks one by one. So similar there will be there. So atoms will be deposited onto the substrate surface one by one. So it will be developing a thin layer of epitaxy. Okay, so thin layer of silicon atom. Basically here in case of epitaxy, we are going with silicon epitaxy. Silicon epitaxy means we will be depositing a silicon layer onto the substrate. Okay, so substrate is there. Okay, so suppose this is the support, this is the support on which this substrate is placed. So into this substrate we will be depositing a layer of thin layer of epitaxy. So this thin layer of epitaxy will be your this thin layer that is of silicon, or we call it pure silicon. It will be very pure silicon. This deposition is called your epitaxy. Okay, So in molecular beam epitaxy, we will be using evaporation method. Like there will be pure silicon. Suppose this is wet silicon. We will be evaporating it by using electron gun. By using electron gun, we will be evaporating its atoms, and these atoms we will be depositing onto the substrate placed here. Okay. So this is the method we will be taking. We will be seeing the schematics later into the next slide. Okay. So we'll see what are the some advantages related to beam molecular beam epitaxy. As it's named molecular beam epitaxy, we are going to evaporate the atoms of the silicon, and that evaporated atoms will be made to deposit onto the substrate. Okay. So here the advantage is it is useful for precise layer. Okay. It will be providing you a precise layer, hence lower autodoping. So in the previous class we have seen what is autodoping. So in case of autodoping, what happens, there is a chance of doping when we are having two layer deposition. If on n type we are depositing p type, so at the interface there is a chance like some p type can be moving to the n side, and n type atoms can move to the p type. So there is a auto doping, or while we are cleaning the surface, okay, the wafer we are cleaning after the epitaxy, there is an in situ cleaning process and etching of the wafer is done. So while doing that, there is a chance like there could be some gases that can mix to the substrate and can have a deposition, that is unwanted deposition of atoms available into the chamber that can alter the you can say quality of the vapor deposition. So that is your autodoping basically. So in case of molecular beam epitaxy, it is useful for a precise layer deposition. Okay, or you can say it is advantageous in case of we are having a more pure epitaxial layer deposition. So this is providing this precise layer that will be reducing the autodoping problem. So autodoping problem will be reduced in case of molecular beam epitaxy. Another one is it is useful, like it can be operated with low temperature. Okay, so with respect to vapor phase epitaxy, this molecular beam epitaxy can be operated at low temperature. Okay, so if it is operating at lower temperature, then there is some advantages, like if it is able to deposit at a low temperature, so this can have a more precision. If we are having a low temperature, we can control the layer deposition. Okay, so here controlled growth rate or doping. So here also, what type of doping we want into this silicon, the doping and the rate of growth of the layer can be controlled in case of molecular beam epitaxy. So it is better controlled layer deposition can be taken place by molecular beam epitaxy. And also there is no boundary problem. So in case of vapor phase epitaxy, we have seen like this is the support and then this is your substrate. So once the gases are being flown, if the gases are being flown, it is like it is having a higher boundary layer at the, if x is zero here and x is suppose l is here, so from x ranging from zero to l, at l side it is having higher boundary problem. We call it boundary layer. So higher boundary layer will be there. So there is a chance of boundary problem in case of vapor phase epitaxy. Okay, but in case of molecular beam epitaxy, there will be no boundary problem available. Okay, so these are some of the advantages of molecular beam epitaxy. But some major issues with molecular beam epitaxy is it is having low throughput. So we were discussing yes, the major issues related to the MBE. Okay, So in case of major issues that come across is low throughput. So it is having less number of you can say depositions with respect to time. If we consider, it will be taking very large time and it is very expensive. Okay, so this method of molecular beamlithography, it requires very much sophistication into the system. Okay, so the system that we will be using for this method is very complex actually. Okay, so it is a complex system and expensive, and its efficiency in terms of like production, how many chips can be produced or how many chips is can be having epitaxial growth by using this with respect to time. If we consider, it is very less. Okay, so its output is basically very low in terms of production of these chips. Okay, so next we will be seeing the symmetric process that is being used, okay, for this epitaxial growth. So this is the symmetric, or this is a chamber that we will be using. So into this chamber, there will be this portion is your electron gun. Okay, so here electron gun is there and a silicon source will be there. So a silicon source will be there. So this is your silicon source. So this is silicon source and this is electron gun. Electron gun will be targeting the silicon source. Okay, so this is your silicon source. So this silicon source, once the electron gun is targeted onto the silicon source, the silicon atoms will be evaporated from here. Okay, so this silicon atoms will be evaporated and it is made to move towards this. So this is your substrate. So we will be placing this substrate. Okay, so this is your substrate. So these atoms from the silicon, by using electron gun, once it is evaporated, it will be moving towards the substrate. Okay, so the deposition will be taking place. So at the substrate, there is a mechanical shutter. So this is a mechanical shutter, like this is a mechanical shutter. So this is mechanical shutter that can be manually turned on and off. So once we want deposition, it will be turned on, this shutter will be removed. Otherwise, there will be a shutter that no atom can reach to the substrate and no deposition can be taking place. So this is a mechanical shutter. Along with that, effusion cell. So this effusion cell is, it is having some chamber, or you can say heater type, and some what type of doping we want. So if we want to deposit only silicon, we will be using this electron gun and silicon source, and the silicon atoms will be deposited. If we want to deposit a silicon atom along with a doping, so either we want a p-type of doping or n-type of doping, with respect to n-type and p-type, we will be using the dopant. So this effusion cell will be used for dopant actually. So similar to the silicon source atoms will be evaporated to be deposited onto the substrate. Similarly, if we want a p-type or n-type of doping, or and p-type and n-type of layer deposition onto the substrate, we will be using the silicon source along with the effusion cell. So it will be turned on. So this turning on will be done by this mechanical shutter. So this is also a mechanical shutter. It is like an closing and opening. Once we want a doping, we will be opening this shutter, and doping atoms and silicon atoms will be combined, and combinedly it will be deposited onto the substrate. If we want only silicon deposition, we will be closing this shutter and we will be turning on only this shutter to deposit only silicon atom. Or along with the dopant, we can use to turn on this shutter, and the dopant and silicon atom will be deposited here. Okay, so this is a thermocouple used to detect the temperature actually. So it will be detecting the temperature of this chamber, like at what particular temperature it is being operated. Okay, and there is a coil. So beneath this substrate, there is a coil, hot coil. It will be used for heating this substrate. Okay, and heat shielding is there to avoid the heat transmitting from this position to throughout the chamber. Okay, and along with that, this complete process takes place into a high or ultra high vacuum condition. Okay, so in case of vapor phase epitaxy, there were chemical reactions taking place. So into that chemical reactions taking place, there were a chance of defects, or there were a chance of some error. Okay, so that error can cause the reduction in quality of the deposition of this epitaxy layer. So in case of molecular beam epitaxy, ultra high vacuum condition or ultra high vacuum chamber is used for this complete method to take place. So to generate this ultra high vacuum condition, two type of pumps are used. So these are titanium sublimation pump, another one is turbo molecular pumps. So these pumps are basically very sophisticated pumps, or we call it very high standard pumps that are complex and sophisticated. Okay, so this is very high end pumps are there that are oil free bits. Basically these are oil free pumps. So what is the advantage of using oil free pumps? Like if we are using oil, those pumps that is having oil as some input that is for their operation, some oil is being used. So that oil molecules can affect the quality of this epitaxial layer deposition. That's why to avoid any defects that can be arising because of using the oil related pumps, these complex and sophisticated molecular turbo molecular pumps and titanium sublimation pumps are used to ease out the vacuum available into the chamber. So whatever air or layer medium is present into the chamber, that can be vacuumed out by using these type of high end pumps. Okay, and also this complete process takes place at lower temperature. Okay, so generally the melting point of silicon is greater than around 1400 degrees centigrade is there. Okay, so in case of greater than, like if we want to melt it, in case of MBE, what we do is evaporation. So into this evaporation we have to melt it. So up to 1400 degrees centigrade if we want that temperature. So this for melting, basically instead of using a heater, what happens if we are going to use heater for this melting, it is very difficult to implement a heater to provide a heating up to 1400 degrees centigrade. So instead of using a heater, this heater use is avoided. Instead of that, we will be using electron gun. Okay, so here electron gun is used for providing 1400 degrees centigrade temperature, so that evaporation of silicon atoms can be taken place. Okay, so instead of using heater, we will be using this electron gun here. Okay, along with this complete process, this is a viewport. So from here, what type of reactions or mechanical states are being taken place, that can be viewed from this viewport. Okay, and there are some characterization techniques are also used. So in this case, like molecular beam impregnancy, if we are performing the deposition along with the deposition, what we do is the similar, like this is taking place at ultra high vacuum condition. It is being taken place at ultra high vacuum condition. So if it is going to be taken place at ultra high vacuum condition, then it is very suitable to provide a platform and environment for characterization. So what if a material is there? Okay, if a material is there, if we go for characterization, means we are going for characterization. So characterization means to find out different properties of this material, okay, or layer. So this material we will be going for characterization. In characterization we will be detecting its like properties, like optical properties, electrical properties. So the type of properties can be identified by using characterization. So in this MBE chamber, there are different characterization methods inbuilt into this chamber itself, as these characterization methods require ultra high vacuum condition, and this ultra high vacuum condition itself is available into this MBE chamber. So this characterization methods are used inside this MBE chamber directly. So it is not requiring a separate characterization chamber. So this MBE also supports self characterization conditions, and the characterization techniques can be implemented into this chamber itself. So it is one of the advantage also. So in the advantage we can note it down. So in the advantage case we can see, like, it supports self characterization environment for different characterization techniques. So this MBE provides a platform and environment for different self-characterization techniques. So different characterization technique can be implemented into this chamber itself. So it is, you can say, it does not require extra processing for characterizing a particular layer or particular material into this chamber itself. Okay. So this is like how the MBE, molecular beam epitaxy, is performed. Okay. So this ultra high vacuum that we condition we consider here is, that is of the range, like it is of 10 to the power minus 8 to 10 to the power minus 10. Its unit is torr. Okay. So this is the unit to measure the vacuum. So this type of range is required for ultra high vacuum condition for operating an MBE process. Okay. So we will see some advantages and disadvantages with respect to vapor phase epitaxy and in case of MBE. So the similar we have already seen. So in case of here, if we consider here, so here precise layer is deposited into a molecular beam epitaxy, but if we compare it with respect to vapor phase epitaxy, there is the quality of layer that is being deposited into vapor phase epitaxy, it is not up to that mark like in case of molecular beam epitaxy. Okay, so it is having controlled growth rate, but in case of vapor phase epitaxy, it is not that growth rate, and that growth rate, smaller growth rate is not possible in case of vapor phase epitaxy. Okay, so if a smaller growth rate is not possible, means this in case of vapor phase epitaxy, if we compare here, the control growth rate means here the possible growth that we can have deposit is from 0 to 0.1 micrometer per minute deposition can be taking place to 0.3 micrometer per minute. Okay, so this is like the controlled growth rate minimum we can have, 0.01 micrometer per minute deposition growth. But in case of VPE, vapor phase epitaxy, the smaller growth rate is not possible. So the minimum that can be possible is 3 to 4 micrometer per minute. Okay, so this is like smaller growth rate is not possible in case of VPE, but in case of molecular beam epitaxy, we can have a smaller growth rate also. Okay, the layer growth rate we call it, and no boundary condition is there in case of molecular beam epitaxy, but in case of vapor phase epitaxy, there is the problem of boundary layer problem basically, and it can be operated at low temperature, but in case of VPE, it requires higher temperature. Okay, so there are some advantages and disadvantages. So based on the our application, we can go for this method, like which method we should be using. Okay, and once we are talking about boundary layer problem, so in boundary layer problem, what happens is there is a gap between the substrate, the gas flow that is flowing through the substrate, above the substrate, that can have a higher distance between the layer of flow of gas to the substrate. So this boundary layer problem arises. So deposition of epitaxial layer at the farther substrates will be smaller. So the rate of growth is reduced in case of VPE. Okay, so in case of VPE, varied growth rate is there because of this boundary problem. So to remove this boundary problem, in case of VPE, what method we have implemented is, so instead of this type of holder, we have used tilted type of holder. Okay, so here substrate is placed. So instead of this, this type of method is used. Okay, so in case of VPE, we have used tilted substrate. The substrate holder is tilted to reduce the boundary problem. And another method to reduce the boundary problem is reducing the chamber pressure. We can reduce the boundary problem. And another condition is by increasing. So another method is by increasing the gas flow rate, we can reduce the boundary problem. So if this is the holder, if we are flowing the gas at very high speed, then there is a chance like the boundary layer problem can be reduced. So high flow rate of gas can reduce this boundary layer problem. Okay, so this is the MBE. So we will be seeing some points related to MBE. So basically, what is the condition? So in case of MBE, the condition for MBE is basically it requires very high vacuum condition. Okay, so what is the advantage of very high vacuum? Very high vacuum, or we call it ultra vacuum. what is the advantage of this very high vacuum is, like, if we are having a very high vacuum condition or ultra high vacuum condition, then it can reduce the surface contamination problem. So if we are using ultra high vacuum into the chamber, then it will be having advantage, like it will reduce the surface contamination problem. So the quality of the layer deposition will be very good. Okay, so it will results in high quality epitaxy growth. High quality epitaxy layer will be there if we are using ultra high vacuum condition. Another one is no collision. So collision of atoms will not be there if a vacuum ultra high vacuum we are using, then collision of atoms can be avoided, so that can have a better quality of epitaxial layer growth. Okay, so this, in case of silicon epitaxy, this ultra high vacuum is called part of MBE. So what are the advantages that we have seen with respect to MBE? That is because of this ultra high vacuum condition that we are providing in case of silicon epitaxial growth. Okay, so this is called heart of MBE. Okay, to maintain this ultra high vacuum, there are some methods that is used. So this ultra high vacuum condition is maintained by the method, and that method is called load lock system. So in load lock system is like, it can be obtained by using two methods. So one is like, so suppose this is where we are placing the substrate. Suppose this is the it is a box. Okay, this is the box. Inside that we are having this substrate we have placed, and we will be rotating it. Once we will be rotating, the next time this will be, the substrate will come to here. So like, while placing the substrate into the chamber, it is one of the difficult method, difficult process to place the chamber, because the chamber should be having a vacuum, proper vacuum should be there into the chamber. But to place this substrate, if we are going to avoid this vacuum condition, the quality of the deposition will be reduced. So this type of method is used, like load lock system. So substrate is placed here, and this is an airtight, we can say. There is an opening here and an opening here, and we will be placing this substrate, and this substrate will be rotated and it will be going out here. So this will be like input, and this is as output. So once we will be taking it out, it will be placed into the chamber, main chamber it will be placed. So this is another chamber, this is the main chamber. So this is how the substrate can be placed from outside world to the main chamber. So this is called like a load lock system. Another part of this load lock system is, this is, suppose this is the main chamber, outside this we will be having another chamber. So it will be a vacuum chamber. Okay, so ultra vacuum. Okay, ultra vacuum is there. Another one is this, here the substrate will be placed here. Okay, so this is substrate, and once substrate is placed into the outer chamber, this is outer chamber. and this is your main chamber. So substrate is placed into outer chamber, then this is vacuumed out. It will be vacuumed out, and this this your substrate will be placed into this, then it will be now transferred to the main chamber. So this method is, this is another method to provide the vacuum condition as it is. So once we should be having a vacuumed chamber, that means once the vacuum has been created, we should not be taking the substrate from the outside to the chamber, because it will reduce the vacuum condition. Okay, so to maintain the proper vacuum condition, we will be using this load lock system to place the substrate from the outside world to the chamber. So this is one of the complex method. It is having very complex operation methods, so it takes very much time. So to create that vacuum, it takes a long time. Like, it takes days to create a vacuum. That pumps that we have used, the molecular pumps, these molecular pumps take days to create a vacuum inside this chamber. Okay, so it should be avoided, like there should not be any error and there should not be any contamination, so that the complete process can reduce its meaning, whatever meaning it is going to apply for it. Okay, so that load lock system is used to provide the substrate from the outside world to the main chamber, that is complete ultra high vacuum condition is there. The next we will be seeing is cleaning, like how the cleaning will be taking place. So in this case, in situ cleaning in MBE. So in MBE, in situ cleaning is done by two methods. So one method is called baking in vacuum. So in vacuum, baking process is taken place, that is taken place at around 1000 to 1200 degrees centigrade. Okay, so by using baking method, we will be cleaning the substrate. This cleaning comes after MBE. After we have deposited epitaxial layer, after MBE we have made, after MBE, the cleaning of substrate is to be done by baking the vacuum at 1000 to 1200 degrees centigrade. So in between this temperature range, we will be cleaning the deposited layer. Another method is sputtering. So in sputtering, like removing, sputtering is similar to etching. Okay, so it is like we will be cleaning the substrate, or we will be removing the waste materials from the substrate, that is done by sputtering method. So it is called sputter clean by using organ beam. So by using organ beam, that is inactive gas. So by using inactive gas, we will be cleaning this waste materials available onto the substrate. So this is called sputtering. Sputtering by using organ beam. Okay, and this takes place at around 800 degrees centigrade to 900 degrees centigrade. Okay. So instead of baking, this sputtering method is preferred. So this is preferred over this baking method. So this is the complete MBE process is there.